What's going on, everyone? Will Trubshaw here along with Andrew Fish for IUSTV Sports, bringing you another IU women's basketball recap. And there's another IU women's basketball win today. The Hoosiers improving to 5-2 on the year and 3-0 in conference. A great start after their latest win, a 79-56 victory over the Illinois Fighting Illini. Andrew, for this number 20 Hoosier team, I mean, a lot of things went well today. They had four different players in double figures. They forced 25 turnovers of the Illini, shot 48% of the floor, and probably one of the most impressive, at least offensively, 19 assists on 29 made shots. They did a lot of things right today. What to you stood out as the most important key to their success?
Well, I think just the ability to adapt, and they obviously had a ton of defensive success today. They dominated Illinois from the get-go with a great first quarter defensively. They forced, I mean, Illinois had 25 turnovers. Now, quite a few of those were unforced, but at the same time, there was some really solid defensive play from all five of the starters. And then you also saw a kind of a breakout game from Nicole Cardano-Hillary, who we knew that she had the potential to kind of stretch the floor and be a ball handler when Allie Papert isn't on the floor. But she came in, hit some huge three-pointers to really distance the Hoosiers from the Illini. And it felt like it gave some relief to Jalen Penn, who didn't have her best game. But if you have Cardano Hillary hitting threes, Jalen Penn doesn't have to be the marksman. And if they both are hitting threes, I feel like you have a really good chance to put up a lot of points against anybody you play. So they got the ball inside in this one. Another example of how the Hoosiers can win so many different ways is today they did it on the defensive end. They did it by feeding Mackenzie Holmes inside. And then they had a big bench effort from Nicole Cardano-Hillary where, you know, next game it might be Jalen Penn hitting five threes, or maybe Allie Papert will break through and she'll score 25 points, or Grace Berger will continue to have success that she's had throughout the season. So the versatility of this IU team, the depth of this IU team, and it might have even gotten deeper with the performance from Cardano-Hillary, is something scary for the Big Ten.
Yeah, you know, that's something you keep mentioning, Nicole Cardano-Hillary. That's what I want to ask you about. She had 14 points today, which was her season high with IU, but that's certainly not her career high. Last year, she had a 41-point game back when she was with George Mason. She was George Mason's all-time leading scorer before she transferred over as a grad transfer to IU. So she is a potent scorer. Terry Morin said post-game, you know, this is kind of what we expect from Nikki. She's a volume scorer. This is what she does. But it looked like it was taking her a while to finally get in that rhythm. You know, she got the waiver from the NCAA a couple weeks ago, and the Hoosiers have only really had three or four games since that point. So she's kind of been getting in the flow of things. But her previous high before today was 3 points. So I guess just how much does this change the game plan for the Hoosiers on offense? And for teams that will be playing them this year, knowing that, you know, this is another asset that the Hoosiers have that they can use to stretch out the floor.
Right. Yeah. I think that you mentioned it. Stretching the floor is going to be huge. With the offense that the Hoosiers are running this year, it seems like they want to stretch the floor early and then they want to feed Mackenzie Holmes late. And I have adding another great shooter in Cardano-Hillary, it's going to add just another weapon, another depth, as, you know, if Grace Berger or Jalen Penn or Allie Papert get in foul trouble, you feel like you have somebody coming in off the bench that is just as lethal scoring the basketball and also handling the basketball, that it feels like there's never a break for any of these opponents. Every single game, no matter who's on the floor, they can score. All five starters plus Cardano-Hillary, you feel like they have a good chance to go for 20 points. So it's the depth factor. It's the shooting from deep factor that she brings this team to another level off the bench.
For sure. So many good things to take out of the win today, but there were a couple hiccups for the Hoosiers. We mentioned they had those 25 turnovers that they forced, but they only scored 24 points off those 25 turnovers. Now, obviously you're not going to score every time down the court, but you'd like that number to be a little higher, especially considering how many turnovers they have just in the first half alone. The Hoosiers left a lot of points on the board there. Secondly, they had those 19 assists, but they also turned the ball over themselves 16 times. And, you know, Terry Morin talked about it a lot post-game too. She wasn't totally happy with the consistency of this team. They had some good stretches where they played really well on both sides of the floor, but then they would have a sequence where they looked fantastic on offense, but then they were lazy coming back in transition on defense, and they got burned by this Illinois team, which, again, you know, every Big Ten team is going to pose a challenge. But for IU, this was their 10th consecutive win against Illinois. You know, this has been a team that they've dominated, and they gave them some really easy looks. And there were some times where IU looked flustered on the offensive end, coming off a good defensive set against this team that is Illinois. And you look ahead to the next game on the schedule now. It's Maryland. Maryland is currently ranked higher than IU in the top 25. It's a team that IU, that was one of the few mountains they could not climb last year. They couldn't get past Maryland in three tries, playing twice in the regular season, once in the Big Ten tournament. So what does IU need to correct? What do they need to be wary of, given some of these flaws in an otherwise pretty good game, so that they don't lose to Maryland, so they can pick up that win that's eluded them so far in the last year?
Well, I think for starters, Allie Pappard needs to play like Allie Pappard's capable of playing, and that is, 20 points, close to 10 assists. If she does that, you feel like you have a good chance to win. Another thing they need to do is they need to hit three-pointers, which obviously today Cardano Hillary did, but Jalen Penn didn't shoot it particularly well today. They are shooting under 30% as a team from deep, and if you're going to beat good teams, you have to hit the deep shot. Another thing that is going to come into the equation is taking care of the ball. You mentioned the turnovers today against Illinois. They are a top 10 team in the nation, the Hoosiers are, keeping the ball from being turned over. So if they can keep that going, throw in some three-pointers, and then continue to have Mackenzie Holmes play as well as she has in deep, and then you get Allie Pappard going, I don't see a team that's really going to be able to keep up with the Hoosiers in the Big Ten. That being said, Maryland's a great team. You have to play A-plus ball to beat them, but I think that the Hoosiers have the depth and have the players in place that it's going to be an awesome matchup.
Indeed, that's going to be fun to look forward to. First game after the new year. So with that said, we want to take the time to wish all of you watching right now a happy new year, a safe and healthy 2021. Hopefully things get back to normal. Hopefully we can get some fans in the stands to see some of these games, because it'll be a good stretch the rest of the way for the Hoosiers in Big Ten play. Once again, for Andrew Fish and everyone at IUS TV Sports, I'm Will Trubshaw. We'll see you next time.